Okay guys, how are we doing? It's Sam here, back with our next instalment of Habits. And this one is Habit 7, and it's all about a daily greens drink. Now, one of the reasons why I like taking a greens drink, and I'm not a massive fan of supplements, but one of the reasons why I think most people should take some kind of greens drink is because most of us are highly kind of deficient in most things. The thing is now, guys, our food isn't as nutritious as what it was 60, 70, 80, 90, 100 years ago, purely because of how the vigorous farming techniques that we use now. So we're kind of like farming all the minerals and nutrients out of our soil these days. So that's why I recommend everyone, or most people — there are a few exceptions which I won't go into now — but most people should be taking a greens drink. And one of the drinks that I recommend is Lean Greens. A lot of you may have seen me talking about this on Facebook. If you know me in person, then you'll know that I'm a big fan of Lean Greens. And purely because of this reason, I've tried lots and lots of different greens drinks in the past, and I've probably sampled about 20, 30 different greens drinks in the past. And the reason why I like Lean Greens is because it tastes a lot better than a lot of the other stuff out there on the market these days. It's a bit more mutual tasting. The thing is with greens drink is, you know, anything with wheatgrass in it, it's going to taste pretty rank. Yeah, but the reason why I like Lean Greens is because the blend that they've used, or one of the reasons why I like Lean Greens is because the blend that they've used isn't as harsh tasting. But having said that, guys, if you're expecting banana milkshake, then you're not going to get that. So that's one of the reasons why I like it, is because of the taste. And you can mix this into all sorts of things. You know, some people like to just take it with water. Some people like to disguise the taste in smoothies. Milkshakes, doesn't really matter really, but like that's one of the main reasons why I like it is because of the taste. The other reason is because of what it does to your carb cravings. Now, what happens is when you pound your body with nutrients, what tends to happen is your hypothalamus, which is in your brain, which is a part of your brain which is which kind of like controls hunger and cravings, that sends a message that sends kind of like calms that part of the brain down. So really good for helping you with those extreme sweet cravings, carb cravings. Because the thing is, here it is, guys. Yeah, the body doesn't crave food so much; it craves nutrition. So if you're kind of nutritionally depleted, which a lot of people are these days because of what I spoke about earlier, the farming techniques, then what tends to happen is you'll tend to be, from a physiological perspective, you tend to kind of crave a lot of crap a lot more. Now, we're not talking about emotional carb cravings or sweet cravings. That's a completely different reason. You know, if you, every time you eat, basically, it's either because it's physical hunger or emotional hunger. If it's physical hunger, then it's because your body is nutritionally depleted and you've got to get those nutrients on board. If you're emotionally, if you're eating because of like emotional hunger, it's because you're either bored, stressed, or upset, and you're looking for something to make you feel better again. All right, so that's another reason why I like Lean Greens, and the other reason is because of the blend. Now, the blend is helps with digestion. There's a lot of digestive enzymes in there, and it can help with alkalizing your body. Now, you know, you hear people talking about the blood having like a pH scale, you know, acid and alkaline. And what tends to happen is when we make poor food choices, things like fizzy drinks, sugar, processed food, alcohol, coffee, things like that, that kind of pushes us into a more of an acidic state. So here's the thing, guys, yeah? Disease, bacteria, germs, virus cannot thrive in a healthy alkaline environment. So when you kind of like pound your body with nutrients, then you kind of push yourself towards a more of an alkaline state. So it improves oxygen in your system, basically, yeah? Improves overall energy. So, you know, there's a couple of ingredients in there, which I'm going to go through in a second, which help boost your boost your energy levels. And it's also great for aiding detoxification as well. So here's the thing, guys. When people start detoxing, what tends to happen is they haven't got enough nutrients to help them detoxify. So there's certain ingredients in lean greens that can help with detoxification, and it can also help target stubborn leg and bum fat because of the broccoli that's in there. So these are the ingredients, guys. So I mentioned them earlier. So we've got spinach in here, wheatgrass, barley grass, alfalfa there. So all these are highly dense in nutrients, you know, lots of high in vitamin C. So it's going to be great for your immune system, especially during the winter months. So let's just crack on with these. We've got chlorella, spirulina, broccoli. Broccoli has got something in there called indole-3 carbonyl that helps with detoxify excess estrogen. So it helps to target stubborn leg and bum fat. Blueberry and blackcurrant extract. So again, high in vitamin C, and also got a lot of antioxidants in those things as well. So you get a highly concentrated blend of blueberry and blackcurrant extract. Other ingredients, and this is the reason why I like lean greens, is because of the ingredients. There are other greens drinks out there with different blends, but I like these because you've got the ingredients that aid digestion, ingredients that aid what we spoke about earlier, the making you more alkaline, ingredients to improve overall energy, and ingredients to target stubborn leg and bum fat. So that's why I like this particular blend. If we look down here, we've got the Siberian ginseng and the green tea. So if you drink a lot of coffee, sometimes you know, like to get a boost, that's fine. But sometimes you get the jitters and you feel like crap afterwards because you're on an energy roller coaster. The Siberian ginseng kind of helps you boost your energy levels like caffeine does, but without the jitters afterwards. Green tea, obviously, I'm a massive fan of green tea. A lot of people are saying, what's the deal with green tea? It's got caffeine in it. Yes, it does. But the thing is with green tea, it has something called an amino acid in there called theanine, which changes how the energy is released. So you don't get so much of a spike as what you would do if you were just to take caffeine on its own in the form of coffee or you know, a processed coffee or you know, like any kind of energy drink, that kind of thing. So green tea is actually fine if you're on detox, if you've decided to do a detox. I'm a massive fan of green tea, guys. So when to take it now, this is personal preference, really. There is no right or wrong. Some people like to take it in the morning. If you take it, here's the thing, guys, when you first wake up, what happens is you're at your most acidic. So what happens if you drink it in the morning, then you kind of push yourself further out of that acidic state and into more of an alkaline state. Also in the morning, it's kind of like an insurance policy, I find as well. Personally, I take it in the morning with water. However, that's not right. Some people don't like doing that. So it's not the be all and end all. If you take it in the morning, then it's kind of like an insurance policy. So if you miss any kind of fruit or vegetables in your nutrition plan, you've kind of backed it up because you've had that hit of nutrients in the morning, all right? And that kind of sets yourself up for any like carb cravings that you may be getting, especially mid-afternoon or late on in the evening. If the taste is an issue, some people can't taste. Some people haven't got a problem with just manning up and necking it. Other people like to kind of like disguise the taste in smoothies and milkshakes, which is fine to do that as well. It's personal preference, really. And that's pretty much it, guys. Yeah, so that's lean greens. That is habit 7. Like I said, I want you to try and get that into your week or your day. Make that a part of like your daily routine. That's another reason why I like it in the mornings, because you wake up, smash it one out in terms of your lean greens, and then you can get on with your day. Yeah, but it's different for everyone. All right, guys, so I hope that's made sense. This is habit 7, and this is all about your daily greens drink, and that was all about lean greens. Peace out.